各位，復古潮流的興起源於大家對過去美好時光的懷念，或是對當今工業大量生產出來的產品欠缺獨特個性的生活方式當中的一種反思和抗衡。今集介紹每個年代都有的復古潮。復古潮流通常包含古著 Vintage 和古董 Antique 這兩種概念，大眾對過去時尚的服裝、家具、裝飾、汽車、音樂和生活方式等各方面潮流都有一種獨特的審美體驗。到底現今C世代年輕人和30歲以上的人所追捧的復古時尚有什麼不同？李嘉文報導。
古老當時興，古舊時尚或者從來都未離開過。由復古衣服、手錶飾物到菲林相機、黑膠唱片，都成為了時下年輕人的時尚穿搭必備品。在多倫多市中心街頭亦匯聚了不少 Vintage 古著店。這間位於 Dundas Street West 的古著店是由來自巴西的 Fisman 於2022年開始營運，店鋪主要是賣奢華復古風格的古著服飾。店主 Fisman 自細已經對古著有濃厚興趣，主動研究時裝設計，人生第一份工就在巴西的古著店做銷售員。當時已經觀察到家鄉小鎮上的人都喜意收藏來自1950、1960年代的衣服，後來他自己都開始不再買新衫，而是去尋找高質素的古著衣服來穿。之後興趣更加擴大至收藏家私、燈飾等等，成為了復古物愛好者。8年前移居到加拿大，就投身於古著行業的 Fisman 見證著近年復古潮在多倫多的熱鬧情況。
I would say like the past like 6-7 years, I would say like because of social media, there's more people like learning about vintage.I would say not everyone's going to keep buying vintage because some people like trends and they come in, they test it, they like it, but they still like go back to like traditional like retail, going to the mall and buying stuff. Canada has a long, long, long story of, you know, like vintage and antique because like if you drive outside of the city, for example, you're going for a cottage, there's a lot of antique shops.So vintage and antique are quite similar, but they're like different because antique are items that are like 100 years old. So they're very special, they're collectible. And now there's a new generation because of Instagram and TikTok. They're like finding out about the beauty of vintage. You know, there's like fresh, it's different and nice. And of course, when you wear vintage, you for sure it's going to stand out.
在 Z 世代出現的復古潮， Fisman 亦提到是因為20-30年前的舊物過時的時尚趨勢，對 Z 世代，即是1990年代末至2010年出世的年輕人來講，反而是從未接觸過的新鮮事物。舊物例如錄音帶、底片相機，在 Z 世代眼中反而是獨特的物品。而在社交媒體的分圖下，見到不少網絡紅人都開始嘗試復古風格元素的打扮，年輕人亦會想跟上呢股復古潮。復古風格是指當代人模仿歷史上出現過的生活風格、潮流及設計，通常都是指20-30年前的時尚，亦是對過往時代文化的致敬。提到復古，相信大家都會想起 antique 和 vintage。不過 antique 古董和 vintage 經典的都有分別。Antique 古董是指已經有超過100年歷史的舊物，例如古董家具、瓷器等等。古董物稀有之處在於物品包含著某個年代特有的手工藝和風格，有後世無法複製翻同一韻味的寶貴價值。在這間已經有50多年歷史的古董店，店主 David 收羅了由17世紀初的古董至1950年代的舊物。
Younger people are interested, and but there's less people, less younger people interested, but there are some still interested. So they're buying different things than their parents did. So our trend has been to you know, buy things that are selling, and the things that, you know, their parents collected aren't so popular. But there's a growing trend with younger people who are interested because they see the quality of items that, you know, you can go to IKEA and buy a piece of furniture that might last you 5 or 10 years, but this piece here has lasted 150 years already and will continue to last another 150 years.
David 亦指出，近年在多伦多华人社区中较受欢迎的古董是 English Bone China 英式骨瓷，和一般瓷器不同之处是骨瓷会在烧瓷的时候加入动物骨灰，令瓷器更坚硬，用手指弹下碟背的时候会听到清脆的回音。于他而言，古董的热卖趋势一直都变紧，20年前已经过时的家私，现在的价值可以直升4倍，又变回抢手的古董。
So this is a lovely early Swiss from Switzerland music box. So it plays 12 songs, and before radio and records, it has a cylinder, and the teeth pluck all the little notes, and each tooth has a different note to it. So when you play it, it's very full sounding, and it's got all these little bells that kind of highlight certain notes.
而不同于古董的 vintage， 字面上是解过去某个年代最经典的，亦都是指1920年代至1980年代制造的物品。通常这些物品到现在仍然可以使用，例如首饰、衣服、打字机等等。不过能够完好无缺地保存下来的 vintage 物品并不多，而 vintage 衣服亦可以称为古着。卖古着的店主 Feisman 要通过不同渠道四出搜罗，先找到质素依然保存得好的古着。其中一个常见的方法就是通过拍卖。 Feisman 指一些庄园或者豪宅屋主搬屋的时候，会将不再需要的家私、地毡、玻璃器皿等等整成一份商品目录，再联络买家，然后商议价格。
About culture is that like between the 90s, Prada developed a very modern approach to clothing. So they wanted to be the future of fashion. So everything they did looked very like fresh and new, didn't look like old, you know. So they kind of came across very like fresh, young, and look like, you know, something more like the future. We're talking about materials and the quality. So this is 100% wool, very warm, very cozy, very like nice detailing. You can see very like, you know, like blue little lines here, very beautiful. It's like a very classy blazer that if you buy right now, you can keep for 20, 30 years because it's a unique item.
在这个快速时尚发展很流行的年代，消费者都习惯每季跟着潮流买新衣服，很快就舍弃只是穿过几次的衣物。大型企业以售卖廉价但品质参差不齐的衣服赚取利润，但快速时尚对自然环境造成严重的污染和负担，而复古时尚于近年卷土重来，就鼓励到消费者改变购物习惯，购买二手衣服去延续衣服的寿命。2022年一项针对2041名美国消费者的调查显示，1/3的美国人有惯常地购买 vintage 产品，当中23%的人购买古董是想装饰屋企，另外17%为复古物爱好者。而在4月举办的 Toronto Vintage Clothing Show， 一年举办2次的 Vintage Show， 就给了个机会一班 Vintage 爱好者一次过看晒各类型的复古物，同时都给了好像 Feisman 咁的古着或者古董商家和收藏家去摆卖各式各样的旧物。
The show to me is like a unique opportunity for vintage, not just for buyers, but like for everyone that loves the culture. Twice a year, you got a place to come with your friends, find beautiful things, go home, and understand that this is culture. It's not just about items, it's not just about buying things, it's about like understanding that like whatever happens in the past is always going to be part of a present.
展览当日亦见到不少年轻人的身影，对新一代而言，穿搭不再只是着重于要跟得上潮流，而是要凸显到个人独特性。另一方面，年轻一代在购买产品同时亦关注背后议题，古着符合到永续时尚的理念，减少浪费，舒缓由快速时尚带来的过度生产问题。所以展览对于一班 Vintage 爱好者来说，亦是个机会去见下志同道合的朋友。
So I always come home with like a giant bag of things. There's so many amazing pieces. There's a lot of like 1970s pieces, a lot of accessories, anything that like umbrellas. Even I saw a lot of really cute umbrellas that I thought were really cute. There's a lot of just really fun prints.
復古潮在每個年代都一直以不同的方式重返。對時下年輕人來講，復古的魅力除了是可以突顯到個人獨特的風格之外，更加是提醒了大家在物質和玩樂主義下正是過度消費的問題，以延續購物的使用壽命，走向持續的消費模式。
好了，今天節目時間就到這裡，下星期再見。